I know everybody does year-end reviews, but why 2016?
Did anybody even like this year?
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to episode 66 of A Brew With You. I am one of your hosts, Blake Mickle, accompanied by Mr. Rocket Man himself, Danny Brajas.
Because I'm a Rocket Man.
Rocket Man. Running around the... What does he
say? Running out of fuel in here. Or it's something about running out of... No, it's...
Running out of now, fuel, I'm Elton John.
But you know what just messed with my head? You remember that? I think it was like a Volkswagen commercial where everybody is singing different and wrong lyrics. I think that I think that just got into my head.
Oh, I'm drinking a different beer on the show right now. I was drinking this before.
It's 66, man. Free love.
Burning down the streets and heaven. Yeah, actually, you're right. That was like a Volkswagen commercial, and that was the exact same song that was going on that they were like trying to recreate.
Rocket Man, Rocket Man.
Burning down the streets and heaven.
Is it?
Let's just running, look it up. I don't want to fix the facts in this because
running out of air up here alone. I don't know.
You know, the funny thing is, this is Danny's second to last show on A Brew With You.
What?
And we don't have, I have to get in the habit of not fixing, I have to fix some facts in there or somehow get an, I have an idea for an intern, believe it or not.
You want me to be the intern?
Oh my God, you could be like, you could still do fix the facts.
I could be a remote intern.
You really could.
Yeah.
I didn't even think about that. We have to talk about the future of the show, seeing that you're gone.
I mean, I did it remotely from the cave that one time.
You did?
Yeah. Remember? We forgot to do it on a show.
That's right. Hold on.
And we interrupted our regularly scheduled program to show me in the cave fixing the facts.
Rockin' Man burning out his fuse up here alone.
Ah, burning out this fuse. Burning out his fuse.
Up here alone.
That song was definitely about him being gay.
You think so?
Yeah.
I thought it was just about traveling.
I think it was about him being gay.
It probably was, but I mean...
Yeah.
You know, Adam Carolla did this really funny bit about how we need to find a way to, you know, find heirs for all the very talented and awesome gay people. Like Elton John, for example... Like needs to donate his sperm and like give it and then have like a real true heir to a woman. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yes.
like we need people like we need more Elton Johns, right? So we need it not just adopt because I think he adopt kids. I think
more George Michaels.
Exactly. Like we need more. We're gonna get into that, but we need more. Like how? Like we need some of these very talented gay people to reproduce, like donate their sperm, and then get more heirs. You know what I'm saying? It was really funny. He was doing it in a more funny context, but I thought that was a very funny point. Actually,
it's a very valid point.
Yes. This is our 2016 year review. So again, it's one of those odd shows where we're not really doing topics. We're breaking out the year by breaking it out little by little here.
We're going to punch 2016 right in the face.
Yeah. So how about we just kind of talk about, first off, just talk about our Christmases a little bit.
Sure.
Before we do, I'm sure you're thirsty. You've been doing a lot of traveling. We'll get into that in a minute.
Right.
So let's just get into the rigmarole and just see how it goes here. I got to take this goddamn hat off. I have a winter hat on right now. My hair is going to be a mess. I don't care. It's like it muffles my hearing. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's covering my ears. Now my hair's all weird.
Just to call him out, moments before we sat down, he insisted that he was going to wear the hat for the show. And I was like, I don't see what the problem is. Why is that a big deal, Blake?
Yeah, it doesn't work. It just doesn't work. My hair's going to be weird for the second to last show you're on. So deal with it.
I think that was the first time that I've ever said, why is that a big deal? And even said, why is that a big deal, Blake? And you didn't immediately plug.
Patreon.com/BigDealBlake.
There you go.
There you go, buddy. I was just really worried about my hair there for a second. My hair's going to be bad, so whatever.
Yeah.
So let's just get into it. For any of you joining us for the very first time, A Brew With You is where Danny and I will try a beer that we've never had before while discussing random topics broken up Tuesday through Thursday on YouTube with the whole episode being released on Friday. If you like what you hear, like what you see, like what you feel, go to patreon.com/BigDealBlake to get this entire episode a week early along with your extra rewards and perks.
Just do yourself a favor and go get the rewards.
We had a little dilemma here. Danny has been traveling. We'll get into that in a minute. He literally got off the plane. He literally landed 3 hours ago, and he's here now. to get this episode for early access for you patrons and also get ahead of schedule because he's leaving next week for KC. So I brought the beer, but I figured that I also thought of a place to drink as well.
Sure.
Normally this is Danny's place to drink, but I think Danny will disagree. Since this is the year review, it's 2016. I figure that the backdrop, our backdrop would be the year review as well. Like what happened, things that happened in 2016.
That makes sense. That
so
makes
just 2016, sense. Begrudgingly 2016 on the count of three. One, two, three.
2016.
All right. So because of the you know, the schedule change and everything like that, we had a I brought the beer. And I brought the reason I got this beer is because we know we're done with the holiday cheers. We had our theme month for October. We had our theme month for December. Not doing a theme for January, but you know, I don't even know about dry January. We haven't even talked about dry January this
right.
year. It doesn't look like it's going to happen this year. We might have to take a month off or delay it another month this year. Danny's leaving. We're both going to LA. It's the last show coming up. It's like, there's too many things going on to not drink. That sounds horrible, but
it might have to be dry February.
Yeah,
it
maybe.
It might have to be.
Yeah, I might have to bump it a month. Yeah, we'll have to figure it out. But
we'll talk.
Yeah, well, I definitely want to do it. I just, it's just, January is not a good month.
I need to do it.
Yeah.
It's like a must.
So maybe
I need an easy out to shed like 10 pounds.
Because I don't want to do it for January because then we'll find there's so many reasons to drink. And I mean, it sounds bad, but I mean, you know what I mean? A lot of celebrating, a lot of, for better or for worse. But I think maybe February we can bump it to. It's a shorter month of the year anyway.
Even so, though, 28 days. I mean,
yeah, it's
that's better than nothing.
Yeah.
And like I said, I definitely need it. And it'll be something to do for me. I think that'll be really good going into the launch of the new store.
Well, we're not making it official, but let's just say February for now. That
sure.
February is going to be our official dry month of the year. We're just bumping it in a month because too many things are going on in January.
So many things.
So why I brought this beer? Surprisingly enough, we've never had New Belgium on this show. On the show, I thought we had Accumulation on the show before, which sounds familiar, but I don't think we did. But I looked at my archives. I looked at all the notes, and I didn't see that we did. So. Huh.
Yeah, I can't think of one off the top of my head.
Yeah, so I don't...
I mean, I know we've like talked about Fat Tire and stuff like that, but...
Yeah. New Belgium is actually one of the king breweries of seasonals. They do a lot of seasonal beers, and this is one of their seasonals that's brand spanking new.
Ooh, shiny.
The reason why I got this because it's called Whizbang, which reminded me of a firework, like New Year's, like fireworks. And that's
sure.
really the only reason why I got it, because I felt like start the year off with a bang, you know, sort of thing.
Right.
That's the reason why I got this. And again, it's very seasonal. So it's a New Belgium Whizbang, a hoppy blonde ale, a complex hoppy blonde ale bursting with mosaic hops and a multi backbone for a full flavored taste explosion. 5.7 ABV. That's really about it. You know, New Belgium's come out with seasonals like every month. It's I mean, not literally, but they are a seasonal, big-time brewery. Whenever they have festivals here in Chicago, it's like, oh, I recognize Fat Tire and Unsessionable and the hop. What's the one with the paddle?
I think it's just called Blue Paddle.
Yeah, it's like you recognize the crankshaft one is one, the one with the gears on it.
That's Third Shift.
Third Shift. So you recognize some things, but then like
they
have like
30 ale?
Beers you never heard of before. So this is, I don't know if this is going to be a continuation, but it is a seasonal now.
A special release, according to the case.
Special release. So that's it. That's everything you need to know. A Hoppy Blonde Ale. Go over the description.
Hi-yo.
So ready to try some New Belgium Whizbang.
Yeah.
All right.
I like blondes.
So your second to last show. We're not going to get sentimental now. This is just another show, but it is our year in review.
You aren't. I might.
Not yet. Cheers, my friend.
Cheers.
And Estrovia. Yeah. Again, for the umpteenth time I say, as always, I love beers that have the title or description and it tastes what it's described as. I taste a hoppy blonde ale. That's what I taste. And I'm very happy with that. I'm not eluded or misguided by that at all. I like that.
Yeah.
It's like a winter, not winter, but it's like a cold, refreshing beer. It's got a very unique smell to it, though.
I just don't know that weird. I'm a fan of mosaic hops because it seems like most beers with mosaic hops always have the same kind of, how can I put this? It's either Mosaic or Simcoe. I know that Simcoe, and this is like a true fact, like Simcoe is commonly like described as cat pee, like the scent of it. but
hey, you like that cat piss beer?
Yeah. But I don't know. Mosaic, it's got kind of like, not in the sour sense of the term, but kind of like a weird funk finish to it. Every time I drink a beer that's like using Mosaic, like a strong, you know, amount of Mosaic hops.
You're talking about smelling like cat piss. There's a lot of beer. Like, I think Fat Tire is a great example. Like, the same from New Belgium. They're probably their staple beer, which smells very funky. Like, Fat Tire smells very funky, but that's a good tasting beer.
Yeah. It's almost like smelling this, like if you take a, like a really like good smell about this, it, to me, I don't know about you, it smells a lot like weed. Just a lot like
it
weed.
It does. You're right. Yeah, I know. It had a funky smell to it.
So
it does smell like weed.
So a better word to describe the flavor that I am tasting in the back of my mouth would be dank.
Dank. Yeah. I smell that dank. That Maui Wowie.
That's what's happening.
No, but I smell that too. I'm not. Yeah. Danny has a better. I think Danny has a better palate than I do in terms of taste and sense of smell. But I do smell that. I do see where he's coming from with that. It's very interesting. At the very end of the show, if you're joining us for the first time seeing a brew with you, we rate the beer at the end of every episode. Mainly the show is about conversations, having a talk, about topics, coffee talk, but beer talk. But this is the year review, and we're not just reviewing the show, because we kind of just did that a couple of months ago for the 1 year anniversary show, episode 52. So this is more of like the whole year in a combination of what we've done too, a little bit.
Right.
So, but before we do that, Danny.
Blake.
Let's fix some facts.
And air some airs. Are you ready for this?
Uh-oh.
In an interesting, and it can't, it like, because it worked out this way, and it would have been even funnier if it worked out this way on my absolute last episode, until Danny Barra's homecoming happens and debuts in theaters. there are none.
We said everything correct.
I watched the entire episode in the airport today, and the only one that I could have like done some digging and got some facts on was when you said sweet potatoes are healthier than regular potatoes, but that's fact. Everybody knows it. You don't have to Google that. And I mean, that is true. Sweet potatoes are better for you. They're more nutritious starch than normal potatoes.
True.
That literally was the only like thing that we
it's not too surprising, because we had a special guest, and a lot of the special guests was a lot of Q&A and like giving opinions. It's not necessarily facts,
except for that one time that kind of kickstarted this whole thing when we had Grant Simon on the show, and we got all of the
Grant.
We got all of the Greek mythology stuff wrong.
Oh yeah. And that's, I was embarrassed by that, because I know I was really rusty with my Greek mythology, and I love my Greek mythology. It's just been,
likewise.
It's been a long time since I've really dove into it, so I gotta finish this beer before I keep on drinking this one. So, before we get into 2016, it's the first time I've seen Danny. He's been away for several days, and it was the holiday. So, how was your Christmas?
It was good. Stressful as always, because that's what happens in my family. But what did you say?
Like
why?
Like typical family stress.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Cooking, you know, and do this and do that. Yeah, yeah.
Of course. You know, mom freaking out about, you know, two things not being clean. You know, blah 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 blah. All of us trying to calm each other down. Everybody just, you know, doing plenty of drinking. It's a pretty standard Mexican family. So it's.
Speaking of which, before I get off topic, continue in a second. But
sure.
I was thinking, you know, when you leave. You know, I'm going to go back to the old stomping grounds in Wheaton for a couple sentimental reasons. Yep. You know, I have no family there, but a couple, long story short sort of thing. But I figured I would reach out to your folks while I'm out there and stop by.
Please do.
Yeah.
Because I was going to say, obviously, because I had a ton to do, like, and not a ton, but I mean, I do have a lot to do. But because basically I left from the suburbs to come back to the city just to kind of pack and get ready for my trip to Kansas the past couple of days. I didn't bring anything back with me, but you have Christmas presents at my house, and you have and mom, because she does it every year, also made tamales, which you're gonna have you got to get some.
Oh man, damn. Okay, so also, I need to get a trip out there soon. Then
just so you know, I did already tell Jeff that I would force you to share with him. So there it is. It's on. No. It's on tape. It's on tape. No. Jeff, there you go. No. I'm doing the best I can.
I'm not going to. I might share with Connie because her birthday's coming up, January 4th. So
that's a stellar birthday present.
Might treat Connie.
Because I got to tell you.
And then Connie, you can eat the tamales right in front of Jeff's face. And you don't have to share with her.
I ate a lot of them. It was awesome.
Oh, your mom's cooking. I miss it very much.
But yeah, no, they would absolutely love that. I believe that I will. I mean, I'm definitely going to try and get a day out there before I officially leave. But just in case I don't, you do have gifts there.
Okay. I'll have to make it out there in the next couple of weeks then.
What happened was when I was doing all of my typical Danny last minute shopping, the stuff that I ordered for you was out of stock. So it shipped late.
That's all right.
But it's there.
And oh, it's at their place.
Yeah, because that's where all of my packages were going.
I got you.
Also, just in case it arrived on a day that I wasn't here, I don't like boxes sitting outside of my apartment gate.
Yeah, I hate that. Yeah, I hate that too. The FedEx, UPS, et cetera, delivery people, they get creative on where they deliver the packages, though. It's like sometimes it's behind a plant or sometimes behind a door when it's like in front of my place. So they get a little creative.
If they're doing that, that stuff's cool. But, you know, I've walked up to my building before and just seen like boxes sitting outside the gate. And I will just pick them up and like put them like in front of the front door and like behind the gate.
Look at you, good neighbor.
Just so it looks like, you know, oh, the gate is closed.
Just for you. Yeah. That's great. My Christmas was... it was interesting, in a good way. I brought the lady to see the family. Ooh, and my family never met my folks. She never met my extended family, never met my aunts, my cousins, my grandma, anyone like that. So she went from like 0 to 10. You know what I'm saying? From not just like easing the parents and the godmother and the aunts and uncles. It was just like, meet everybody. Mm-hmm. So, but I wouldn't have brought her out there unless I knew she could handle herself, and I know, or in addition, I knew that they would love her. So it's like, right. I knew that it ended up being a great weekend. Oh my God, dude, the food. Mm. We had kapusta and kielbasa and plotsky and pierogi and crab and tuna and babka. We had so much babka. If you don't know what babka is, look it up. It is a Polish sweetbread. It's like a sweetbread with raisins in it. It's like a sugar and powdered sugar on it. It's unbelievable. The reason I've never made it, because I feel that's the pinnacle of Polish cooking. Like you make your plotsky and pierogi and gumki. Right. But babka, let's put it this way. My grandma is the master of making a babka. She doesn't make it anymore because she's sick and she's 94. But her daughter, who's my godmother, she's been doing it for like 20, 25 years. And she just finally started getting it right. You know what I mean? Like how hard this is to make. It is like, it is, to my opinion, if you can make babka, you can make any kind of Polish cooking. So I've not even reached that. Yeah, I'm still the grasshopper. I was trained grasshopper before the Polish cooking.
You're still a Padawan.
Yes, exactly. I have to get my hair cut and I have to get my training done and I have to go through the cave and see my father, who's really Darth Vader.
Ponytail thing.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. But it was a very good holiday. We talked about last episode.
Traveling was good. Easy trips.
Yeah, man. I've been lucking out, man. Knock on marble right now. But, you know, I had a long streak there of really bad traveling woes. And lately I've been having great. I mean, it was really weird. We went to Midway and like, okay, we got to get early. It's the Friday. Christmas on Sunday. So we got there early on Friday. No one was there. No one in security. We walked right up to security. We didn't even wait in line. We walked right up to security. 5-10 minutes for security. 10 minutes, I'd say. And that was it. I was like, what is going on? And we waited around the airport for 2 hours.
Right. So I am a genius. And in the midst of my rushed packing. I totally forgot.
You mean for today?
Or? No. This was going to Kansas.
Okay.
So, I mean, my travel was easy, right? I got out of work. I went to Union. I had like an hour to kill. So I had a beer or two, hopped on the train. No big deal. Christmas Eve, gift wraps, and then Christmas happened. But I had my backpack, had my suitcase, everything ready to go. I left with plenty of time. I usually like to give myself, you know, time to grab a drink, maybe a little something to eat before a flight. And I make it all the way through security. They are scanning my bags. I'm not paying any attention to it. And I'm just like looking at the belt and I'm like, where's my stuff? Why is my stuff not coming out? And woman walks up. She's like, does this bag belong to you? And I was like, yep. She's like, you need to meet me over there. And I was like, oh, okay. And I'm at this point, I'm not worried about a thing. I'm like, that's weird. She's like, I need to look in your bag. And I was like, sure, that's fine. And she's like, you don't have any knives or any sharp objects in here, do you? And I was just like, I don't think so. And she opens up the zipper and she's like, are you sure? And I just right away, I was just like, fuck. I left my utility knife in the back pocket of my backpack.
I didn't even know you had a utility knife.
Yeah, well, the thing that sucks about it is I wouldn't have been so broken up about losing it. I'd have been like, fine, just take it. I'm sorry about that. But that was a groomsman gift from Mike.
To me. Yeah.
So it had my initials carved in it, on it and everything, and I had to surrender it because there was no possible way to get it back. They told me, they're like, you can't even mail this because it's a knife. And I was just like, damn. So I had to surrender it, and that's how my trip to Kansas started.
Oh no.
Yeah.
So you don't have it. So what, do they have it in holding or anything for you at least?
No. Like apparently she told me, she's like, no. She's like, once we put that stuff down the chute, she's like, I don't know what happens to it. I was just like, great. So it's in some collection of forbidden airport stuff now.
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah. So that was crappy.
I guess I know what I can get you for next Christmas then.
More knives.
Yeah.
Tons of knives.
I have a nice little collection of knives, actually. I have a butterfly knife. I have a switchblade. I have a little bit of a collection of knives. I have my grandfather's carving knife. I usually carve the wood carvings, the animals. I have a nice little collection of knives. But, I mean, like, they're knives. You use them. You know what I mean?
Right.
Like, yeah, I don't know. Some of them are for show, but I don't know. I kind of like knives. It sounds weird. I know, but
nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, I don't know. So you went to Kansas City to do some apartment searching, huh?
I did. I did a lot of apartment searching. I found one, thank God. That's the best part.
Hey-o! Completely different from the place you live in now, I'll tell you that much. Holy shit. You got to actually have lighting in your place.
A lot, because there's a ton of windows in there.
And oh, my God. You're going to give you all, like, so positive all the time now.
And it's on the third floor, too. So it's just, like, it's all light.
Oh, that's great. I love that. Third floor's not too bad.
I'm no longer in a cave.
Yeah, that's not too bad. Third floor's not too bad.
No, not at all. But I lucked out. I saw a lot of places. It sucked because it was literally the first place that I saw.
Mm-hmm.
And then I saw like 10 more places. And out of all those, I went all the way back to the first one. And I was just like, I mean, you have to look, but I really wish this was the last one I looked at so I don't feel like I wasted this entire day.
Wait. So how many places did you look at total then?
Like 8.
Oh, that's a lot. Yeah. That's like completely understandable in my opinion, because it's a city you've never been before. You don't even know, like, yeah, I'm sure you saw some pattern. After 8 places you've seen, you saw some pattern in places.
Yeah.
You're getting a feel for the location. You've never been to Kansas City, so you're understanding the location and also too, like when you're looking at apartments, you know, you have the variety of you're living in a complex versus like a house, a duplex. There's so many different options and varieties, you know, that, and as far as you've got experience of that in Chicago.
Right. And this one, so now this company that I went with, they flat out told me, like, we've been kind of waiting for a lot of people to leave so we can just rehab and renovate. And this is one of those buildings. So like all brand new appliances, like the granite countertops, you know, brand new bathroom fixtures, like a totally remodeled bathroom, like brand new hardwood floors. Really nice. For the price. Definitely not something that you would find at that rate here in Chicago. However, I will say this. I did look at one in like this whole big like apartment community that was a boss apartment.
Boss!
It had a rooftop like community hangout. It had a swimming pool. It had a huge gym in the basement.
Yeah, what happened to that?
Like, so the thing of it was that basically is a little bit more expensive than what I'm paying here.
Oh.
And not by much. Like, I couldn't believe it. I was just like, if this were in Chicago, this would be like a
$2,000 a month.
14. I would have guessed like probably like 15 or 1600 a month.
Yeah.
Easy for a one bedroom, but boss apartment. And that was the hot leasing agent.
I don't know if I could do that though. I don't know if I could.
I was tempted. I was tempted, but I was just like, no, Danny, no, you're coming here to not spend this much money.
Yeah. But you like your place though. That's the bottom line, right? You got the other place. You got.
Yes.
Yeah, that's good. That's great. So that's secured and deal. And now Danny has dropped the ball that, you know, he's only in Chicago for a week now, and we're only going to film one more episode. So the last episode we're going to record is probably about 4 or 5 days from now, and that will be Danny's goodbye episode. So if you're a patron or a viewer that like to hear, now's the time to ask Danny some questions or anything you would like to see before Danny leaves and the show takes a new turn.
Right. A review. A Danny in review.
Yeah.
I will say this, though. My trip back, I pretty much lucked out the same way you did. When I got to the airport, I checked my bag. It was really fast. But I had a lot of time to kill. So the lines for security and check-in were huge. And I was just like, all right, well, I'm in no rush. I have hours. I was like, I'll walk around at the outer concourse and see what they have. KCI has a Boulevard Brew Pub from Boulevard Brewing, which was great. Sat there, had lunch, had a couple of beers. By the time I went back, nobody in the security line.
No, like, shit.
Not a single person. I was that worked out incredibly well.
Lovely.
Yeah.
So yeah, then I went to Kansas City, found an apartment, saw the city a little bit, and then literally flew back today. Got in at like 5. We're shooting like a couple hours after that. So Danny obviously has a lot of rounds to say goodbyes to in the next several days here. So, but before we continue on with the year of 2016 review,
yeah,
this really threw me off. I'm not gonna lie, 5 days. I thought you were gonna stick around to at least like the 12th or something of January.
Yeah, no, it. I had to kind of argue for even that, because I was initially told there was flexibility in the start date. Then I was told, how do you feel about reporting on the 9th? And then I got told, well, we're having a meeting on the 4th. We'd really like you to be there for it. At which point I kind of just emailed him back and I was just like, listen, that you're basically
Skype it in this day and age. Like, you can't Skype it in.
That's basically what I said. I was like, if you want me on the phone, I can be on a conference call. There's no problem. But basically, if you're asking me to be there the 4th now, then that means that I have to move around that. And you're giving me like 2 days after I get done with Christmas stuff.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, that's...
Yeah, you give them you a little bit of slack.
And I told him, I was like, I'm in KC through the 29th. If I land back on the 29th, you're literally giving me like 2 days to pick up and move. Like, I can't do this meeting on the 4th.
Right.
And they said, cool. They were fine with that. They understood. But even so, it's still the 9th. And that's still really soon. So... working with moving companies, trying to get there a couple of days ahead.
Get it done, man.
So that I just have a day or two to like organize and then jump into work.
All right, everybody. Well, we will get into more of recapping Danny's time here on A Brew With You and his future adventures. But now it is time to look back on 2016.
Ugh.
So Danny, I broke down 2016 into several different categories.
Here, sure.
From highlights to movies to celebrity deaths to music to video games and the beer. So let's start off with some highlights, shall we?
The Donald.
A lot of bad stuff in 2016. Not even like everyone's just talking about celebrity deaths. But this year, you know, obviously the biggest thing I think that consumed this year was the political year. It was the political year.
Right.
And what really hurt this year, I felt, was that, you know, everyone was so vocal, so hostile, so angry, so bashing their heads over this stuff when no one talks about politics on a daily basis. No one is that emotional about something they don't care for ever. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
What I don't get is people get so mad for something they don't know anything about. They don't know anything.
I'd say 90% of the time. That's 90% of the time it works every time. I would say that's accurate to a point. I know people personally that do the research and that are very like argumentative and passionate about, you know, who they're voting for and whose names they're putting on those ballots because it means this tax break or that tax break and things like that. And I respect their opinions, but you're absolutely right. We get a lot of people who are just whining about it. Like, oh my God, oh my God, the world is ending. However, I'm 99% sure that I said it on the episode way back when a year ago, like a couple of weeks into us starting this, when the Cubs were in the playoffs. They weren't in the series championship, of course, but they were in the playoffs. I said that the year that they win the World Series is the end of our days.
Ah.
And I'm pretty sure that we're coming close to the end of our days because the Cubs won the World Series.
Which brings me to the next point of 2016.
I'm going
to
drop the mic and leave you, Chicago, because the Cubs just won the World Series. No offense, Cubs fans. I love the Cubs. I'm happy they won. Pretty sure it's marking the end of our calendar.
Yeah, well, that was the other big thing. As the Cubs win the World Series after 108 years. That's big, man. The reason why I think that's big is because, yeah, we have a little bit biased because we're from Chicago. But, I mean, even if you're not a baseball fan, that's crazy.
Right.
You know, a team that hasn't won in 108 years, that's pretty insane.
That also...
I would have paid attention to any sport.
It was also just like a funny like people watching thing to me that one event unified the entire city for the most part, except for Jeff because he hates the Cubs. But then literally like a week later, the election happens and everybody hates each other.
Yep.
Everybody hates each other. Yeah. And it was just like, hey guys, remember when the Cubs won the World Series?
Hey,
we were all hugging each other and crying.
Yeah.
And now we're hugging each other and crying, but for a different reason.
Well, for the after the Cubs won, we had sad sports news with Kobe Bryant, Peyton Manning, and Alex Rodriguez retiring from sports. That's a lot of childhood heroes. Different major sports, and they're all leaving their major.
Right.
You know, that's pretty big. Nothing really big in hockey in terms of retirements. I mean, actually, a lot of these older guys are still playing, which is crazy. Like Jager, for example, he's like 42, I think he's still playing. So no one too
classic
big in
Jager.
We're not gonna get into this because we already talked politics. But Brexit happened.
Yes,
and that was that I remember the stock market just like when Trump won became president. When Brexit happened, the stock market crashed and then picked up immediately. You know, not it didn't rise, but it picked up immediately afterwards. But again, we don't know the long term effects yet with Brexit. We don't know the long term effects of our political.
Are we still going to be able to count on James Bond now that Britain has exited the Union?
Yeah, good question. Good question, Danny. Maybe that'll be the next name in the next James Bond movie called Brexit. James Bond in Brexit.
James Bond will return in Brexit.
Going back to sports, we had the Olympics this year.
Rio.
Michael Phelps, tearing it up.
Man, that guy is amazing.
Your man, Bolt, getting another more gold that way. It was fun. And Rio,
Rio was a lot of fun because if Phelps, and I don't think he will, I'm pretty sure he's done now, but both him and Bolt went out on top.
And they're done.
The biggest living legends of all time, two of the, I should say. I mean, the Olympics has housed a lot of unbelievable athletes, but I think those two safely got to be two of the best the world has ever seen.
Absolutely. Yeah. It's pretty exciting.
And then you had that dummy Ryan Lochte.
No, we are alive to see it too. You know, it's pretty to look back at it. There are some good things.
There were. Like that was, so you've talked about it before about how much you like the Olympics.
I do.
I'm the same way. Like there were times when I was off at night when it was happening and I'd just have it on the TV.
Exactly.
And I'd be like drinking a beer and screaming and like cheering and be like, come on, USA, let's go.
Yeah.
And then, like I said, we have that dummy Ryan Lochte who also represents us that was just a dummy.
Yeah, well, you brought that up in the news. He did something stupid and, he screwed over his friends, blah, blah, blah. Anywho, not much to talk about this, but just cool fact that Obama visited Cuba in Hiroshima. Cuba was the first U.S. president to visit Cuba in the first time in 88 years, which is pretty crazy.
Mm-hmm.
In Hiroshima, correct me on this, fix the facts. Is it Hiroshima or Hiroshima?
I would bet Hiroshima. Okay. But I would bet that's the actual pronunciation. I'll find out.
But Hiroshima, but I'm sure, is
Hiroshima is probably what we grew up hearing in Catholic grade schools.
Yeah, well, that's two big significant visits by the president, too.
Yes.
And then some sad news. A lot of shootings again this year. Remember, more specifically, the Orlando Gay Club got shot up.
Dude who screamed ISIS.
Yep.
That was another... When Dave Chappelle made his comeback on SNL, that was just another brilliant thing that he did. He's like, just because I scream Wu-Tang right before something doesn't mean I'm part of the Wu-Tang clan.
Yeah, right. Again, don't want to get too into it. There's all the police officer controversy, all the cop shootings and In addition to the terrorist shootings, there was the one in California, and then the one that Apple refused to give up their iPhone information to the FBI. Remember that shooting? And so there's a lot of course, there's always those terrorists, and there was one in France, the one who brought the dump truck or plowed through the people. Remember that?
Yeah,
was horrible. But
the whole I could definitely go off on that and the whole police officer thing. I don't appreciate any badge bashing whatsoever ever. I understand that a handful of them are not good people and a handful of them have done terrible things, but there is no good reason that you should hate on every police officer that you see because two people sucked at their job. Obviously, I know it's a lot more than two, but I'm not saying or justifying any of those acts as good things. You know, they're all terrible things, but it should be a real simple. All of those people, just throw them in jail, fire them, get them off the force. But not all badges are bad. That's my only thing I'll say about that.
Yeah, I'm not saying any opinions about this because I'm just recapping the facts. But it's just that the shootings were brought to light for better, for worse.
Right.
And that was a big theme this year was the whole, Black Lives Matter and Blue Lives Matter.
You could just further arc that and we could have kind of covered politics and everything like that. And again, going back to Dave Chappelle, but it unfortunately seemed like racism was a huge theme of this year.
It was a big theme.
And it was
Trump
just,
and a lot of the comments it was said really the cops. And
it was
the,
really sad.
Yeah, it was
just really sad to just be seeing all of this on the news. And it's just like, man.
But I mean, it also wasn't necessarily, well, my only thing was it was also the media too.
Yeah.
Blowing a lot of things out of proportion.
Yes. They often suck.
And also a lot of these media places got burned in the long run because of their horrible reporting, because a lot of news now is opinion based and not factual based. Which
right. Like right that now, time that Fox said that Elon Musk was the, what's the word I'm looking for?
The founder, the
inspiration. Inspiration for Tony Stark. And it's just, not Stephen Colbert. Who's the British guy?
John Oliver.
Just
lit
them up over that and just called them out on their horrible, horrible fact checking. Cause they're god awful.
And on a personal note for 2016, for Channel Big Deal Blake, which is going through major changes in the next month or two, I'm doing a lot of work for the show, mainly because with Danny's departure, new shows, new branding. I've brought it up on the show before, but there's a lot of work to be done. And also, my schedule is going to get a lot fuller because of personal reasons for job and blah, 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 financial reasons. So, unfortunately, I can't dedicate myself 100% to the show and channel, but I want to. But again, I need bills. Patreon.com/BigDealBlake. But I had the Premium Awards this year. Premium Awards was in February.
That
was a lot of fun. That was some of my highest rated viewed material was the Premium Awards, which Johnny, my co-host for the preamble, and I are currently working on for 2017, the second annual Premium Awards. We're working on that now. And also we did the those were fun because Danny was getting really hyped up for the Batman v Superman. We did the Batman v Superman taste off sponsorship challenge.
Yes.
That was a lot of fun. So I had some good stuff and those things were, viewed pretty well as opposed to my other stuff. But it was fun to do, those are two, really creative projects I did. If you watch those again, there was a lot of work that went into it. Graphically and storyboarding and there's a lot of work that went into that.
And purchasing and maintaining that Cold Stone ice cream.
That's right.
Yeah.
It was oh my God, that was a pain in the ass, man. That was a lot. So if you want to do it, you get it done. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So those are just some highlights.
Thank you to the kind folks at Cold Stone.
That's right. They were great. They were fantastic. So let's move on. So those are just some. There's a lot of events that happened.
Tons.
A ton. But those are just some highlights.
Yeah.
I just want to bring up.
You and I both reached Jesus age.
That's right.
Yeah.
Big time. Let's talk about movies. Now, Johnny and I will probably do this for the preamble.
Sure. Civil War.
But we're not going to be talking about a lot of the more of the Oscar movies or what one. I think we're talking more of movies more up our alley.
If anybody loves
our personality, our combined personality.
If anybody loves Oscar season, it's clearly me.
Yeah, right. We're talking more the blockbusters and the fun superhero and Star Wars movies, you know, like those types of movies we're talking about. So more of the hype movies. So right.
So what is like the MTV Movie Awards? Is that like the Oscar equivalent for blockbusters?
In a way, yeah. Yeah.
Because, I mean, I feel like that's all they focus on is blockbusters. Yeah,
they don't care about anything else.
Best kiss while fighting for ninjas.
Yeah. I bet you that was a category back in like 99. Anywho, so I got some movies. And
Puff Daddy was playing.
I'm going to list some movies, Danny. And I want you to know what your favorite movie of the year was, okay? So we had Civil War, Finding Dory, Zootopia, The Jungle Book, The Secret Life of Pets, Batman v Superman, Deadpool, Fantastic Beasts, Suicide Squad, Doctor Strange, Rogue One, X-Men Apocalypse. This I found, I'll go break off on this. We had four video game movies this year. Four.
Really?
Warcraft, Ratchet and Clank, Assassin's Creed, and Angry Birds.
That was an Angry Birds movie?
Yeah, it was early this year.
Why?
Yeah. Ghostbusters.
How do you write that?
We'll get into that. You didn't hear about that?
No.
Okay, it was early this year. Ghostbusters, Star Trek Beyond, and the second Ninja Turtles movie. Danny, what was your movie of 2016?
Do you want to take a wild guess?
Civil War. Yeah, really. Yeah.
In my mind, it blew everything out of the water, as Marvel usually does. Even beyond their own films, I loved Deadpool. They finally did justice to that character, and Ryan Reynolds got what he wanted, which I give absolute props to for him fighting for that cause and bringing that character to life in the right way, and even going so far to make fun of Fox as putting up the crappy action figure of the Deadpool from the crappy movie Wolverine Origins that did no justice to that story. Civil War, though, how can you not like it? I mean, they brought in everybody. And instead of fighting a villain, which as you always say it, like Marvel just doesn't do villains well, fair enough. They only have like one or two really good ones. Tom Hiddleston, basically.
That's it.
It was just a lot of fun to be like, all right, well, you know what? We're just going to have the heroes fight all of the heroes and Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Biggest news of 2016 movie-wise for me is that Spider-Man, Marvel got their hands back on Spider-Man.
Yeah, that was pretty big news for a lot of reasons, but the future, really. Before I say my favorite movie, I mean, in terms of this list, in terms of it, I forgot the movie Kubo, too. Kubo and the Two Strings, that came out, too. Kubo is actually my top pick. I haven't seen all the animated movies, but it's my top pick for best animated film.
Okay.
For video games, I wanted to talk about those. Warcraft, Ratchet and Clank, Assassin's Creed, and Angry Birds.
How many times did you see Warcraft?
I saw them negative 10 times. It's still amazing to me that in 2016, we still can't make a good movie based off a video game. There has never been a good movie based off a video game. The only thing two closest things you say is Mortal Kombat, which is more of a campy, like goofy film, which is not a good movie, but it's more of just like a old Schwarzenegger flick or a Stallone flick Steven Seagal flick. It's like you turn your brain off. It's not a good movie. You just have fun with it.
It was just an over-the-top action film.
Yeah, and then the other one is Silent Hill, which I never saw. I never saw the original Silent Hill movie. Game's phenomenal.
It's okay.
Yeah.
But I'm also akin to scary movies, so sure. I like that stuff.
But four video game movies this year, and not one of them was good. I won a bet with Assassin's Creed that in a five-day weekend, starting on Wednesday, going to Christmas, mind you, I said it's not going to make more than $39 million, and it made $25 million.
And all of that went to Michael Fassbender.
Oh, my God. Yeah, it did. It totally did, I bet. I thought Ratchet and Clank had hope.
Sorry, everybody. We can't pay you. We can only afford to pay Michael Fassbender.
Oh, my gosh. I thought... I think it was not a good year in movies, personally. I don't think it was. Right now, when we're doing this, it's Oscar season. So a lot of these big movies are coming out. You know, Moonlight came out several months ago. La La Land just came out. Hidden Treasures, Hidden something. I can't remember. Just came out. So a lot of these Oscar movies are coming out. And that's what they do. They sneak them in December in limited theaters so they can make the cut for the Oscar season. I hate it. I hate it. I hate it. But that's what they do. They
Collateral
sneak them in.
Beauty.
Exactly. They sneak them in here to make the Oscar cut. And I hate that. There's no hype. There's no advertising. They just sneak it in. And so, oh,
watch this movie.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So, and then when the awards, the staff, the committee gets a hold of these movies and they pick it, then you get the attention for it.
Right.
I hate it. I don't like that. I'll talk about it on the preamble, I'm sure, next episode.
I would like to see a world
like these
where
movies like Ninja Turtles 2, Ghostbusters, X-Men. I didn't like Rogue One. I'm in the minority of that.
I skipped a lot of those. I actually
Batman v Superman.
I had a lot of fun with Rogue One. I loved KSO too, as a character / android. He was it was funny. It was cool to me to finally be like, all right, these androids just aren't like the bumbling sidekicks. Like, this dude kicks everyone's ass and it's awesome. I had fun with that. But yeah, no, you know what? I feel like a lot of these movies I just kind of skipped over.
Yeah.
I mean, I saw
it was not a good year for movies.
I saw all the superhero movies, but Civil War just kind of owned everything.
Yeah. It dominated. It's the highest grossing movie of the year.
Yes. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Dawn of Justice.
Not good. It was not a good movie.
Even after several viewings and like being like, oh, okay, they did very minusculely put the plot together with that one fast, like 30-second transition line. No, like I don't have a lot of high hopes for Justice League, although I will say that I think Ezra looks pretty cool as the Flash. That's going to be my saving grace for the movie because I love the Flash.
Yeah, well, I didn't put TV in our 2016 because there's too much TV. Because of Netflix and it's just like there's a new TV show that I think that debuts every week now, and it's right. just too
they
much.
They just released another one called it OA, and I was just like, damn it. Yeah. Now I want to watch that too.
I can't. I just can't right now.
And I can't because I got a pack.
I can't review TV. I just can't do it. Maybe I'll do it with Johnny on the preamble, but I just can't do it. But transitioning to movies, though, we'll talk about celebrity deaths, not just with movies, though. There was a lot. Okay, every year there's a lot of people who pass away, but these were the big ones that I'm going to do a speed round right now. Danny, feel free to chime in when you can.
Sure.
But this is a speed round of, I have 26 significant ones that are really big. That's not even like, that's still a fraction of who died.
That's the worst. You're the worst 26.
So starting off right away, we had David Bowie.
Biggest one, I think one of the biggest on the list. I'm really happy that I got to go see the Bowie exhibit at the Contemporary Art Museum here in Chicago. I don't know if you ever got to see it or if it's, no. I don't know, I think it's gone already, but that was awesome because it literally was, you got a chance to peer into how his mind worked, like his notes, everything like that. That guy was a genius.
Yeah, he was a stud and one of my favorite individual performers of all time. This one really hurt me. I think a lot of people like him because of the Harry Potter movies. I liked him more for his personal story. It was Alan Rickman. I just loved his story. He, at age 30, he just dropped everything to become an actor, and then he didn't get his break till he's 43 in Die Hard. So 13 years of like hard work, you know. Number three, Harper Lee, To Kill a Mockingbird. George Kennedy from Cool Hand Luke and the Naked Gun series.
Yep.
He was a great actor. Funny, turned funny too. Nancy Reagan. Sir George Martin, the producer for the Beatles. Frank Sinatra Jr. Gary Shandling. Mother Angelica. Remember the nun, the TV show? The old one with the glasses? She always talked to the camera. She had her own TV series.
I don't know if I actually know that one.
Mother Angelica. She was like 94. She had a good run. China from wrestling, WWE. Here's another big one, Prince.
Yeah. Purple Rain. Yep. It's one of the things that Snapchat did was that they actually created a Purple Rain filter, which I thought was great. But yeah, no, I mean, that's another one. Like, man, I've shared it via Facebook, but there's like a whole little mini doc on his Super Bowl performance from the people, like not athletes or announcers or anything like that, but from people that were working the stage when it was like pouring rain and he was just like rocking Purple Rain.
That's right.
And it's a very cool documentary. If you ever get, it's like 10 minutes long. If you ever have time to watch it, check it out. It's great.
One that we both really identify with that we really love is the greatest of all time, Muhammad Ali.
Man.
That was rough, but that was, you know, he wasn't doing well for a while there, so it was coming, but still hurts.
I am the greatest.
The greatest. Mr. Hockey died this year. Gordie Howe, arguably the greatest hockey player of all time. I said arguably. He's really usually in the top three, but when your nickname is Mr. Hockey,
And sadly, one of my favorite Simpsons references of all time, when Bart writes fake love letters to his teacher, Mrs. Krabappel, and he uses a picture of Gordie Howe as the picture of who's writing the letters.
Yeah. There's one that I threw out there for I know someone who really appreciate this, but Pat Summitt, women's basketball coach for the University of Tennessee, most winning coach of all time.
Yeah.
She has more wins than Mike Krzyzewski, Duke. So put that in perspective. Gene Wilder, Mr. Willy Wonka.
Oh.
Now here's one that you wouldn't know.
Pure imagination.
John Polito. And he was in The Rocketeer, The Big Lebowski. He was the short guy with bald with a mustache. He had a lot of like small movie roles, but that's what I love, actors like this, where he found what his voice was and he just kept on getting work and he just was in a ton of movies. He was a great actor and awesome guy. Arnold Palmer.
Oh,
one of the greatest golfers of all time.
Yeah, another legend.
Janet Reno. Leonard Cohen, hallelujah. That's my prediction for the Oscars for the farewell tribute. They're going to play hallelujah.
Yeah. You know who actually did that brilliantly? Kate McKinnon on Saturday Night Live.
Oh, yeah. I remember
it
that.
Was, and now, like, the joke was she was supposed to be doing it as Hillary Clinton, but it really, she killed it. It was an awesome performance. And he recently came out with an album before he passed.
Yeah.
And Vin is a huge fan. So Vin was playing some of that for me. It's really different, but it's kind of like very cool. It's like the best way I can describe it. His voice is crazy.
Yeah. I like his voice. He was also, one of his most recent songs that was really cool was he did the theme song for the second season of True Detective. Check it out. Badass. It's really good. It's like really good. Check that out. Here's one I put down for you, Danny. From one of Danny's favorite movies, The Magnificent Seven, Robert Vaughn died.
Robert Vaughn did pass. Yeah. He was the gambler in Magnificent Seven, the original. And I already, like, as soon as you said it, I have like six scenes in my mind where he was just totally badass in that movie, because he was kind of at first like this cowardly drunk who had to kind of recenter and get himself back into the game. But when it came down to the fighting, he was a badass.
Yeah. And
it just like he just came straight back into it. It was awesome.
And then back to back, one of my favorite TV. You said one of Danny's favorite movies, and now from my favorite TV shows, from Firefly, Ron Glass died, the Shepherd.
Shepherd, yeah.
Yeah, he died, which was really, that really sucked for me.
That was right around Thanksgiving.
Yeah, it sucked because you know all the hope about bringing Firefly back. Greg Lake. Emerson, Lake, and Palmer died. Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never... Emerson, Lake, and Palmer, you know the band?
No, I actually don't think I do.
Okay, never mind. Alan Thicke.
Yeah.
George Michael.
TV's favorite dad.
Yeah, TV's favorite dad. George Michael. Carrie Fisher. And last but not least, Debbie Effin Reynolds.
Which is like the most heart-crushing thing of all time. Carrie Fisher passes, and then a day later... Her mom.
But I mean, like Debbie Reynolds was...
Come on.
God, she was on top of the world. Like, she did it. She did it all. Like,
yeah.
She did it all. And it just... And I think it's just appropriate that Debbie Reynolds dies at the end of the year. I know people are caught up on the Carrie Fisher thing, Star Wars, blah, blah, blah. But Debbie Reynolds, like, a Hollywood icon back in the day, Singing in the Rain and Mother and a lot of these big movies. What a better, like, isn't it, ironically, isn't it, what an appropriate way to end 2016 with, like, a monster entertainer than Debbie Reynolds.
Right. It was bad enough to find out that George Michael passed on Christmas Day, when a day that I listened to last Christmas on repeat, all the time. And then, you know, everybody's worried about her. Everybody's posting about her. They take away, hope. And then they take away Hope's mom, and it's just like, come on.
Well, that concludes part one of the year in 2016. Again, very depressing note. Not a good movie year, and a lot of celebrity deaths that we all love and enjoy. But we're going to move on with our second part of the year, with music, video games, and our favorite beer
Ooh.
That we drank. in 2016.
That sounds delightful.
So I end on a high note or a drunk note, whatever you may be.
I haven't eaten since one.
I haven't eaten either. I have not eaten for a while. Okay, well, music is something that I always wanted to talk more on the show.
Just like music.
That's I know who that is.
Let's get it on.
Marvin Gaye. Thank you.
Yeah.
So music, I just want to hear your thoughts on this, Danny. Wrote down some albums that I missed out on that I liked and that I didn't care about, that were some of the best-selling albums of 2016. Some artists came back.
This is going to be interesting. But yeah. Let's go. Let's see.
So we had Metallica come out with another album called Hardwired.
Didn't listen to it, but I do enjoy Metallica.
I talked to Jim Perrona, who's a patron, and I follow him on all the social medias. But I enjoyed Hardwired. There was a song that was dedicated to Lemmy, who I didn't put on the celebrity death list. Lemmy died this year. I'm sorry about that. Totally missed Lemmy this year.
The Ace of Spades.
Ace of Spades. That's a really good song on the new Metallica album. I actually enjoyed it, the Metallica album. It was really good. And then coming back again, Tribe Called Quest came with a new album.
That album I did download.
Hell yeah.
Thank you, Apple Music, for making that very simple for me to do. As soon as I heard, one of the guys that I work with, Doug, our beer guy, was just like, did you hear that Tribe Called Quest came out with a new album? And he was already listening to it like in the office. And I was just like, putting that on my phone right now.
Yeah, Tribe, you know, if someone said they're the greatest rap group of all time, I can't argue with that. I mean, it's subjective, but if someone said that, I'm like, I have no problem with you saying that.
Yeah. I'd respect that opinion.
Yeah, totally. And then the other one that kind of had a comeback was David Bowie, right before he died.
Yep.
With Black Star. I only heard a couple songs. The eerie thing about that album is that he wrote that album and some songs when he knew he was going to die. So it was a very different tone for him. Very odd.
But that's another one that's one of the ones that, of course, because of Vin, I listened to the whole thing. And so, yes, I actually was a big fan of that. And funny fact about it is that Vin, he started this last year, but every Christmas he puts together like his own personal like favorite playlist of songs that have come out within the past year or two.
Mm-hmm.
And he always makes myself and Mike a copy. And of course, this one for this year has songs from the new Leonard Cohen,
Cohen
album and songs from Black Star on it.
Hallelujah. No, you got to listen to the True Detective song. Tell them to listen to that. The True Detective season two. Season one is an amazing song too. But season two is the one like, the war was lost. The treaty side.
I'm pretty sure that is the song that is on the album Vin made.
Oh, cool. Yeah. That song's awesome. Gotta go quick with these. Adele came out with a new album. I'm not a huge Adele fan, but I respect her because she has a voice. And
like no other.
Yeah, she has a great voice. And I'm not going to go out of my way to listen to her, but it's like respect sort of thing. Drake. A lot of people love Drake. He's one of the highest selling rap artists of all time. I don't know if I like him or not. I still don't know.
I'm going to be honest. I don't. I mean, well, no, that wasn't even that. That was like last year when the song that I'm thinking of came out. But I don't think I've heard a lot of his new stuff. I really liked his older stuff. When he first came out, I was still listening to a lot of radio. I was still listening to like, you know, the quote unquote new music that's coming out.
Sure.
I really, to be honest with you, I haven't listened to a lot of his newer
stuff. Yeah, I need to get back into that. The Hamilton soundtrack, you know, biggest musical of the year by far.
I actually have listened to that.
I have not, but
just because of somebody, I was one of the coworkers gave me a ride home, and that's what she had in her CD player, and she's like, "Oh my God, you haven't heard it? You have to listen to it." And we started listening to it, and yeah, no, it's a lot of fun, and they're really really well written songs.
Yeah. And then I just want to make a short list of music I don't care about that was really popular this year. Beyonce, Rihanna, Justin Bieber, Blake Shelton, and Kanye West. Don't care. Just don't care. Could be the best song written ever. Don't care. They made the top 50 best selling albums of the year.
Of course, Beyonce was going to do that.
And Rihanna.
Yeah, I like
Justin
Rihanna.
Bieber too.
I don't care about him.
Blake Shelton because he's on the TV show. And Kanye because
you hate
he's
Blake
married.
Shelton because his name is Blake. I think he's hilarious. Actually, I've seen him in commercials and on TV.
Don't take my name. Don't take my name. Kanye, I haven't liked him since.
He's just an absurd person.
Yeah, I haven't liked him in a long time.
The College Dropout is still one of the best rap albums of all time.
Producer and all this shit. I don't care. I haven't heard something good from him in a long time. I'm talking about a long time.
I'm just saying the College Dropout is still one of the best rap albums of all time.
Again, a long time ago, yeah. Right? 2005, yeah. Maybe 4.
Yeah, but still, amazing album.
Sure. He hasn't done anything in 10 years, though. So my honorable mention for band, which is weird for 2016, because they haven't come out with an album in 2010, but they just recently formed in late 2015 and rocked the concert scene in 2016, was LCD Sound System.
Yes.
They're coming out with a new album in 2017. So I love what they did. They came back together, rocked the concert scene. They headlined at Lollapalooza.
Yeah.
And they headlined at ACL, which, yeah, I went to.
Yeah, they were big at both.
And they are awesome live.
Yeah, and it was really funny to see a bunch of people posting about them who had never heard about them before.
Yeah.
It's just like, how did you never hear about them before?
Yeah.
Oh, wait, because I'm a lot older than you by like 15 years.
Right. They are my runner-up band singer.
That was a gross overestimation, by the way.
Sure.
Me being 15 years older would make me,
because they came out in like 2003.
Super creepy. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. But my album of the year, which is Free, because Kanye never signed him and he never got his own record label, was Chance the Rapper, Coloring Book. He's up for a lot of Grammys. He's probably going to win all of them because he should.
This is Chicago boy.
That's right. He's very young. He's like 23 years old, 24 years old. But his album is available. I know it's free on SoundCloud. So just go to SoundCloud. Or if you don't want to go to the SoundCloud for an album, you can go to Big Deal Blake and get this episode and all the other episodes of Brew With You and Preamble and Patreon exclusive episodes. So you can do that too.
Yes.
But if you're not listening to the podcast, you can check out Chance the Rapper's album, which is free. And that album's really good. It's my album of the year. Music was actually pretty good. I think music was actually better than movies this year, personally.
You know what I love that about that too, is that when I first moved into Logan Square, it was just like, to me, it's kind of an old school thing because I feel like you just don't see it a lot beyond like Second City performances do it. They put up posters advertising shows and stuff like that.
Sure.
But there was like a stretch of Milwaukee where you couldn't go 5 feet without a Chance the Rapper poster just,
yeah,
being posted. And I thought that was awesome.
It was a good album cover.
I was like, that is cool. Like, he is everywhere in this neighborhood.
Yeah, it was a good poster. It really was. And it was crazy too, because he didn't have a record label. Mm-hmm. It was all himself. You know what I'm saying? And I think he just broke some records because he's like the highest Grammy. I mean, whatever it is, because of Grammys. But he's the highest, I think. He got nominated for the most awards for like not having a record label or something like that.
That sounds about right.
Yeah, sounds crazy. But let's move on to something that Danny won't have much to say, and
or
none of our viewers will have much to say. Was a bunch
or
of video,
will they?
Were video games, and that's something that I want being selfish about because I like video games.
Sure.
The problem is I just don't get to play them anymore. But I have some highlights and some things to talk about for video games.
Word.
I have kind of a list. Jokingly enough, I have a list of video games that I really want to play, but I never did play.
Okay.
I have some exceptions.
Are these all from 2016?
Yes.
Okay.
They all come out this year.
I have one.
Which one?
And I already played it, but I really, really, really want to see the remastered Skyrim in effect.
Oh, yeah. That'd be cool.
Because I absolutely
that'd be really cool.
I love that game.
You know, I just want to jump on a PS4 already. I don't know why I haven't got one yet. It's so cheap now because it's been out for like 3-4 years already, believe it or not.
Wow.
I know, isn't it crazy? Yeah. It's been like at least 30 years.
That's what I was talking to Caleb about that, and I think we've talked about that as well, but I think I'm going to make the jump back to PlayStation.
I'm going to leave
Xbox and I'm going to go back to PlayStation.
That's a better system. But there were
they also have VR for it, right?
Yep.
Xbox doesn't have
it's the
VR.
It's the best VR.
Yeah.
It's the best
Which
VR.
Which also Resident Evil 7.
Yes. Yes.
I can't play that alone in my apartment in Kansas. I'm going to be crying.
Yeah, you are. Yeah, it's going to be great. I'm going to videotape you on the side while you're watching that. You're going to be picking at your skin. So I have a list of games. I don't want to get too far into this because, one, you don't know much about it, and two, our viewers don't know much about it, but I'm being selfish. But there's a game, it started off the year called Pony Island, where It was on Steam. If you don't know what Steam is kind of like a online portal where you can download games from. It's like you. It's like
surprisingly enough, I am familiar with that because okay. my buddy James asked me if I had Steam, and I was like, "No, I don't." And he's like, "Damn it!" He's like, "I could have given you the new Doom game from Steam," and I was just like,
"Could he give me the new Doom game? Because that's on my list."
Possibly, yeah.
I'll Please do, him. Yeah, because I would love that. I would love the new Doom game.
Continue on. When we talk about Doom, I'll chime in with something about Doom for you because I actually know something about it.
Cool. Pony Island, I'm interested in because this is in a day and age where we can have people. Like, one of the game of the years last year was a game called Undertale, where everything was created by one guy in terms of the graphics, the programming, the soundtrack. He composed the music. He drew everything. He coded everything by himself. And this is the day and age we can live in where if you...
Then he died immediately after.
Right. If you have the ambition, you can... Pony Island's very similar to that where it's just this... It's a very simple looking game. Like, games don't... It's like, there was a time where we had to push graphics. But now it's just like it's more about content and story and uniqueness. And Pony Island's this game where it's one where the devil is making you play this game. And it's kind of like breaks the fourth wall, and the devil breaks the fourth wall.
Interesting.
And, yeah, and it makes you like play this happy-go-lucky game, and it really turns into like this game where he's trying to take your soul, where it's pretty interesting.
So I've had similar experiences, but not at Pony Island. I've had them at Coney Island.
Mm.
Yes, eating too many hot dogs.
Too many hot dogs, yeah. And your soul's gone. Happened to all of us, my friend. Went to Jersey over the holiday weekend. Went to Hot Grill. Same thing happened to me. Had some Texas chili dogs there. Some of the best in the country, my friend. Game called Inside, again, another indie developer. They came out with
a video game,
Limbo. Came out with Limbo, fantastic game.
Did I play that?
You might have seen me play it. I think you've seen me play it.
Is that the one that's like all black and white, where you're like you're a little guy and you're like going through? Yeah,
so this is the same developer. Yeah, same developers came out with this and they knocked it out of the park, apparently. Volume, don't have to go into that, just looking
turn it up.
Volume, yep. Street Fighter V. Street Ooh. Fighter, another Street Fighter game, dude. After all
now
these
that's
years.
That's legit.
Street Fighter V.
Isn't it weird that they've only come out with five of those? When they came out with
that's not right. Because
they came out with but like, are you talking like Alpha and all those other things?
Yeah, there's all these like Street Fighter II Alpha, Street Fighter II Turbo, and Street Fighter...
But what was the real difference in any of those games? Just like an extra character or two?
It was extra characters, graphics, and speed. Like changing the mechanics of the game so they can play better. Because back in the day, you didn't have online to make patches and updates, so you had to come out with a whole new game to update stuff. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So they did a lot of changes to things that never happened. So Street Fighter V. A game I have played is Rocket League. Fantastic game. That actually came out last year, though, so scratch that. Big game that pretty much, and you can have some input on this, Danny, that pretty much was a phenomenon was Pokemon Go.
I watched so many people chase Pokemon, and everybody was unbelievably surprised that I was not on it. And I was just like, I'm sorry, guys. I never really got into Pokemon.
Yeah. I like Pokemon.
Now I wish I did because you're all making me feel like an ass.
Well, that's another thing, a segue into Pokemon Go. This year marks the 20th anniversary of Pokemon, believe it or not. It makes you feel old.
Yeah, that's weird.
And also, I believe...
Back in the day when it was a card game.
Why I respect Pokemon, too. Yeah, well, it was video game. Game Boy game first, then a card game. Pokemon, I believe now... I wouldn't be surprised now that is now the highest-selling video game franchise of all time. It beat Mario.
I thought that happened with Pokemon Go.
I wouldn't be surprised by that, yeah. But... Pokemon's a phenomenon, and I don't care if you hate it or like it, but you have to. That a lot of people like this, and I'm one of them. I like Pokemon. I think it's a very. If you like, I'm not going to talk to about it now, but there's a good strategy behind it. Like, it's a strategy game. It's a role playing strategy game, and it makes you think. It's not just like they're cute little animals. Like, no, like the real way to play Pokemon is like there's a strategy behind it. It's
hatching a Snorlax.
Oh, Jesus Christ!
I don't know what that means, but I heard it a lot this summer.
Yes, you did.
And then
Snorlax is hard to get, and he's a very powerful Pokemon.
And then those two guys walked off the side of a cliff playing.
Yeah, but that was, you know,
go,
2016,
America.
Baby. Anywho, moving on to more death, Dark Souls 3, the game where you have to die in order to live.
Darwin Awards.
Yeah. Dark Souls 3 is a game where, like, the game is intentionally, like, super hard, so you have to die a lot in order to figure out, like, trial and error sort of thing. Okay. But it apparently it just got perfection. Uncharted 4, Nathan Drake is back. The epilogue, the final chapter of the Uncharted series. Nathan Drake's last chapter. Uncharted is a fantastic series. I wanted to play that. Big one. 10 years in development. Final Fantasy 15.
Ooh.
15 Final Fantasies, Danny. Yeah. Dating back to the original NES.
Gee.
Can you imagine that?
Jeebus.
15 Final Fantasy games. Got going. Now we're on to Doom. Again, originally a PC game back in the day. Want to play it. Gave it Game of the Year. I heard it's phenomenal. Seems like good bloody fun. Like sometimes like the game knows what it is. It's just about blood and shooting and killing demons. And so, it's like it knows what it is.
I went through a mini phase there where I was watching... there's like a whole channel of it on YouTube, but it's like basically you're watching a video game as a movie where it shows a little bit of gameplay and it does like all the cinematic cutscenes and just gives you the full story from top to bottom.
Yeah.
I watched it for the new Doom and man, yeah, it looked awesome.
It looks great.
It looked awesome.
And I mean, Danny and I are not like blood porn fanatics or anything like that, but like there's a time and a place for it. And Doom, like, it's like, for example, if you're playing a World War II game, I don't want to see all the blood and guts. You know what I'm saying? It's just about shooting Nazis and like America and historic. But for like Doom, it's like heavy metal, blood splattering, like death. Yeah. It's like, that's the theme.
And it started like, it started a trend like Quake. What was the Nukem?
Duke Nukem.
Duke Nukem, Quake.
Hail to the King, baby.
And there was one more that I can't remember that I'll have to fix facts on, but again, you're some person who rises from the dead, and you're like fighting demons, and
sure,
you can light up hairspray, and like you have all these different weapons. And I used to have it on my computer, and it was great.
Yeah, gonna finish this up because we have to go fast.
Must go faster.
We had Super Hot, which is a PC game, different way of playing first person shooters. Battlefield 1, finally a game that takes place in World War 1, not World War 2. Firewatch, a game about really like a personal struggle and mental illness. Batman Telltale series, huge graphic novel game. How cool is that? It's like you're playing
that
a comic
book. I did have interest in.
Yeah, Telltale. And then
I never finished the Telltale Walking Dead game.
And then Mario finally had his first OS game, Mario Run, that just came out like a month ago. Not even. Very average game. It's misleading because it's a Mario game, but it doesn't feel like a Mario game.
Gotcha.
I have it on my phone. It's very I'll see what Pokemon Go. Danny.
Blake.
We've now come to the year in review for the theme of this show. The best beers we had in 2016.
The best. How are you going about this, though? Because, like, automatically, the one that I would talk about is obvious.
Right.
To me, one of the best
beers. I'm in my top 10 with one honorable mention.
Okay. Why don't we just go through your top 10? I will. Obviously, I have mine. I'll talk about it when you get to it. I'll throw notes down.
You chime in.
I'll throw notes down as we go.
And then if you think of anything that I missed, just throw it in.
Yes.
Okay. So my first, before we get into my top 10, my honorable mention, this is the Brew With You. Let's do an opening. A Brew With You, 2016 Beers of the Year.
Year in review. Beer in review.
Beer in the year. Beer of the year. Year of beer. 2016 year of beer.
Yes.
There you go. So my first one, is an honorable mention before we get into top 10, is Avery Brewery's Chai High.
Yes.
Now, the reason why this is not my top 10 is because we didn't rate it the highest, but we still gave it a decent score. I'm giving this on there for respecting trying something new, trying something different, that what you need to do. It's not like you have to add a bunch of crazy shit, but it's like a very simple, like, let's try this chai vibe into beer. And it did work. It just didn't, as we put it on the show when we did it, we said we can't have a lot of these.
Yeah, that's, it was definitely a refreshing change. Like I said, if I recall, I said something along the lines of it tastes like Starbucks, but in beer form.
Right.
And it did. And it was, It was good, but it's just not something that I could just drink all day.
Right. Number 10 on the top 10 year of beers, I have Goose Island's Fulton Street Blend.
Oh, yeah.
Personal favorite of Danny's.
Excellent beer.
This is the second year we've had it. First time we've had it officially on the show. In my opinion, it's the best coffee beer on the market. Again, we can nitpick and find some hidden breweries or seasonal beers, but I feel that is the best hot coffee brew I've had consistently.
I really hope that they continue to release it.
I agree.
And I hope that it becomes available in Kansas.
All right.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you're not too far away from Chicago, so hopefully
no, they actually, one of the bars I went to actually had Bourbon County Stout on when I was there, and I was just like,
let's do one of those. All right. Number nine is Weiner Brewery's Le Tub.
Le Tub, another outstanding beer and a very approachable sour for anybody who's like, I don't know if I like those.
Exactly right, Dan. You took the words right out of my mouth. It's a sour beer without being sour in a way. It's not too sour, but it's got the elements of it. It's a beer that you could definitely have more of. We were very surprised by that, but it was a very good beer. And they were very great to us on social media. Number eight, I have Three Philosophers Omegang. Jeff brought this for us, and he was hoping to give us another, like at the time, I think it was a 5 out of 5 or a 10 out of 10. I think it was a 5 out of 10. Didn't get a 5 out of 5, but it was close.
I scored that beer very highly because for those of you who didn't see the episode, I have an old love affair with that beer. And one of my first bartending jobs, it just wasn't a seller at that bar, but I drank it all the time.
Yeah.
And when we stopped carrying it, the bar gave it to me for like next to nothing.
Right. It's a great beer. Yeah. It's a very solid beer. High in flavor and definitely high drinkability. Number seven on my list.
Alcohol as well.
Yes, absolutely. Number seven on my list is where Dan and I will disagree on is Victory Brewing's Fest Beer. At the time, I gave this a 9 out of 10, and Danny gave it a 7.5 out of 10.
Yeah.
I'm giving this number 7 because I remember this being very, had a great malty taste that I really wanted to come back for more. And I was just really, I thought it was savory and just, it just really hit my palate in the right way.
Yeah. No, I don't, I think that one just, it didn't really do it for me. That was their Oktoberfest.
It wasn't an Oktoberfest. It was a fall beer. It was like their fall season.
But didn't we have that during Pumptoberfest?
I think you. Yes, we did.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tuber from Lagunitas crushed that beer for me. I think that was part of the problem.
Okay. Biggest surprise, number six, the biggest surprise of the year. Trader Joe's Providential Golden Ale. The biggest surprise of the year.
Right. So brewed by Unibrew. Yep. Which we've had on the show before, and they do fantastic stuff. I will be honest, because I'm moving and I'm trying to, you know, get rid of stuff. I had their special Belgian dark not too long ago. I popped it open and I was just like, you know what? I'm going to drink this because I need to get rid of stuff and I don't want a fridge full of things while I'm getting ready to move.
Right.
Also phenomenal. Like,
and yeah, it was. We were real. I mean, that's why I put it our 2016 biggest surprise of the year. I have these subcategories. Yeah. It's in our top 10, but it's also a subcategory. The winner of our biggest surprise. We should do the beer awards. We should do that. Yeah.
But no, I mean, the Belgian Dark I had sitting in my fridge for probably a good like 8 months. Yeah. And yeah, no, it was very tasty. Right. And yeah, no, they Unibrew. It's unbelievable to me that they do that specifically for a store and that they don't just like sell that themselves.
It's amazing. Yeah. Yeah, and that's why I think it was the biggest surprise is that, you know, when I brew with you on the show, we try everything. You know, we if it's a Budweiser product, Anheuser Busch product, we've tried Leinenkugels. We're not a fan of Leinenkugels, but we still have Leinenkugels on the show.
Yeah.
From Trader Joe's, we will try anything, you know, and that's the whole point. It's not about the big breweries or little breweries. It's just we'll try anything. It doesn't matter. Number five. Hypothesis IPA, Both gave this very high rating for
IPA. That was an English style IPA, right?
I don't know about English style. I know it was just Hypothesis IPA is what. I don't know about English style.
I want to say that they do an English style, that we got an English style IPA.
Okay.
And that would make sense for me giving it such a high rating for an IPA because I absolutely adore English style IPAs.
Sure.
Because of the fact that they really are malt forward beers, like in terms of, like generally, like we've had West Coast IPAs that are just all hops, like all grass, all pine, like in your mouth. But the beauty of English style IPAs is it's like they class it up. It's like, yeah, we're going to feed you all of these flowers and this pine, but we're also going to just back it up with a lot of toffee and caramel, like right in your face right afterwards.
All right. In your face, 2016.
Yeah. Shut up, 2016.
Number four, I have Southern Tears Warlock. I didn't officially have it on the show.
You didn't officially have it on the show, but we did also have it in Indy.
I've actually had it many times before.
Yeah,
but I know you officially have the show. I've had it before, but it's the definitive pumpkin beer. And if you haven't noticed so far on the show,
Hypothesis. Yeah, is an English style IPA.
Okay, great.
But Warlock.
English IPA then. English.
Very well then.
Spots of tea then for the IPA. Anywho, if you haven't noticed so far on this list, I have a very big mixture. I have a coffee blend. I have a sour. I have an IPA. I have a golden ale. I have a pumpkin beer. You know, this is a very big variety. And then we're about variety on the show. So Southern Tier 4 Lock, number 4, my opinion, just beats out Pumpkin. And I'm not even like in terms of like, you know, me on the show. I'm not even a big porter dash stout person, but that actually accentuates the pumpkinness in Warlock, which
that's part of what I love about it is that when you take all of the darker malts like that, and that roast, bitter, like kind of coffee flavor really plays well to balance out that sweet of the pumpkin because pumpkin, as much as I love it, it can get too sweet too fast. And Warlock just nails it. It's the perfect balance. It's so good.
Number 3, we had on the 1 year anniversary show, episode 52 of A Brew With You, Pereres Quadruple.
Yes.
This reminded us of like a champagne of beers in a way. It was very fruity. It had some like fruity and some little nutty.
Super effervescent, very dry.
Yes, very dry. I want to put a side on this, the Saison DuPont. I didn't put on this top 10 list because I felt it was very parallel to this Pereres Quadruple. Very similar to this Pereres Quadruple, but I would have to give it the Quadruple because you get a little bit more flavor in terms of what was in there. But that Saison DuPont didn't make my top 10. That should be I'm officially making that my second honorable mention. So number 2, the runner-up. Our runner-up beer for 2016, which you no longer can get, Danny, Left Hand Brewery's 400-pound monkey.
That was some of the most heartbreaking news of my 2016 is when I met one of the head brewers and he told me that they don't make it anymore. And I was just like, why? And
he's like, do you remember our reaction when we had that beer?
Yeah. He's like, people aren't buying it. And I was just like, I just bought all of it. Just keep making it. I'll keep buying it.
I remember when we had that beer, I looked for that beer more and more, and I couldn't find it. And the reason why is because you met one of the brewers dash owners of the company, and that was the reason why. And that broke my heart. Yeah. I was like, that was one of the, like, it's our number 2 on our top 10.
And that's another, just that's a heavy English style IPA. I mean, you're talking about
malty though. It was so smooth.
That's what I'm saying. It's just like you take all of that grass and like that dirt, and that's a weird way to describe beer, but it is the honest to goodness truth. Sometimes that's how hops come across. But it was just so toffee heavy and just like so biscuity. Like it was like a bready. Just like a bready, like amazing mouthfeel.
It's like right out of the oven, smooth. Yeah. And our last, which is no surprise, which you've heard many times on the show, which is no surprise to Danny.
Nope.
we had it. And you know how high this is coming from me, who's not a big Porter style fan, is Founders KBS.
It was obviously going to be my number
one. Technically, it was our only beer that we've both given 5 stars to at the time. 5 stars. We're now on a 10-point or 20-point scale now, so we would have given it 10 out of 10s. There is apparently a CBS, which Danny informed me afterwards, which I have no idea, which is a rare version of KBS. Yeah,
it's even harder to find.
But KBS, when you're spending about $35 for a 4-pack, you know, again, another part of the show, you get what you pay for. So those are... Well, technically, they're my top 10, but I don't think Danny would disagree to. I think Danny would disagree with one of those.
Yeah, it would have been pretty parallel. Yeah. Obviously, I didn't have a lot of time to go back and cycle through, but if you were listening, we probably had very similar ratings on a lot of those.
Bet you we had at least eight.
Yeah.
I'd say we had at least 8 of the 10. I'm talking about the year now, because remember, we drank a lot of beer last year, too, which didn't count.
True.
But I'd say 8 out of 10. The ones that I don't think you would put on there is Victory, is the FS beer, which you didn't care for as much. And the... No, actually, I think maybe 9, because you like the Hypothesis.
Yes.
So maybe that's it. Just the one beer. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
And just maybe different order of things. But I don't think you would argue with the top 2, though.
No.
400-pound monkey, then KBS. I don't think you would argue with that.
400-pound monkey, I think even like the next week or two, whenever I'd met the brewer, we said it on the show that like if you can find it, buy it, and buy as much of it as you can.
That's it, everybody. We just recapped 2016 from you, from the highlights to celebrity deaths to movies, music, video games, and beer.
Especially the beer.
I hope you enjoyed that recap, and I hope that if you have something to say that we got wrong or misled you or... interpreted something wrong, please let us know. Please comment. Please subscribe to Big Deal Blake, and please tell us. Please let us know, okay?
Just give us the information.
Absolutely. Danny.
Blake.
We need to wrap this up fast because we've been going very long for this one, but it is 2016. It has been a very long year.
Had to be a long episode.
Very factual episode. Very factual. Not too much comedy going on, but very factual episode. So, Danny, what are you going to give New Belgium's Whizbang?
Whizbang. I mentioned earlier, I just don't think I'm a big fan of Mosaic Hops. I'm trying to ignore that in giving this beer the score. There's a couple of things in my head that I compare it to in terms of a hoppy blonde, but in more so like a hoppy... I'm comparing it to a couple of hoppy wheats that I've had.
Sure.
Again, trying not to be biased because I'm not the huge fan of Mosaic Hops. I'd say a 7. There's nothing... I mean, looking past the taste of Mosaic, there's nothing about this beer that really like knocks me out of the park. It's refreshing. It's a very clean finish. It's a very easy drink. I could drink a lot of something along this style, just maybe with a different set of hops.
Copy and paste. Score, description. There's literally nothing I could say that's different from what Danny just said. That was a completely accurate description and score. 100%.
What are you going to do without me?
Exactly. I don't know what the hell I'm going to do. I'm not going to get someone who like has no idea about beer on this show. I'm like, what the hell are you writing this about? I'm going to give it a 2 because I'm not a beer drinker. Get the hell out of my show. Get the hell off my show. Idiot. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us for episode 66 of A Brew With You. I've been one of your hosts, Big Deal Blake. You can find me on Facebook, Twitter, SoundCloud, Instagram, but most importantly, patreon.com/BigDealBlake to get this entire episode a week early along with your extra rewards and perks. Danny,
yes.
Where can people find you when you walk the old dusty trail out into the sunset?
When I ride off into the sunset, that's you right. can still find me at... Yes. You can still find me at Danny Abrahas on Twitter, and you can find me at Danny Adam B to see a ridiculous photo catalog of the thing I call life in Kansas
City.
City, Missouri.
Hey, I love food, and I don't care what you say about Instagram. I love pictures of food. You can send all the pictures of barbecue you want in there, and I'm going to savor my freaking mouth off, and they're like, come see you. And I'm like,
I will take
where's
pictures.
That? I want this. And I go to your Instagram, kind of like, I want that, what you took a picture of 2-3 months ago.
It's called Joe's, and it's in a gas station. Literally, I ate it in a gas station, and it was some of the best barbecue I've ever had. That's true.
I'm going to Kansas City,
here I come.
They got some real pretty women there, and I'm gonna get me one. Yeah, baby. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Thank you, as always, for liking, sharing, and subscribing. And as always, we will drink with you next time. Mwah.